What is good? It's that boy Gibbs back with another one. And bro, today we doing Roman Delize versus motherfucking Nasruddin Imavov. Hey, so last week, bro, it was kind of a wishy-washy card, I must say. It was absolutely a wishy-washy card. And let me go ahead and get my Tapology up. And we'll go ahead and tap into that card. I'm going to give y'all my picks or what I had for last week. Okay, UFC 97. All right, so what a crazy card, man. When I think crazy card, I think Mike Bellot gassing out in the last minute of the fight, last 30 seconds of the fight, really. But, yeah, so Jimmy Flick, we started out hot. I had Jimmy Flick over Malcolm Gordon, submission. Then I had Jasmine Jazdavicius over Priscilla Colcheda. Then I was off on the Johan Lanes, Sharon Patterson, but I cashed in a little bit because I had a feeling that that was a possibility. I had Jillian Robertson over Pollyanna Viana. I was off on the Sierra City fight. Ramon Tavares, he did his thing. I give him credit. He did his thing on that one. Sean Woodson, I was right on that one. I picked right on that one. I called the length being too much for Mr. Charles Jourdain. Next up, I did not have Garrett Arnfield beating Brad Katona. That was a unanimous decision. That caught me off guard. I was like, wow. But and then Mavzar Ivaliov, he'd beat Arnold Allen. I called that one. I was wrong. I called the dog Marc-Andre Barrio to win, but Curtis won split decision. It was a lot of split decisions on this card. And then the Mike Mellott, I did not have Mike Mellott losing to Neil Magny. That actually hurt. Ah, that hurt. Man, Mike Mellott, he gassed out. He was looking good, but you know, Mike Mellott in the third round, that was a sight to behold. So he went and he lost that one. Raquel Pennington, she beats Myra Bueno Silva in a unanimous decision to move on to a 6-fight winning streak. Congratulations to her. And Sean Strickland loses his belt to Drakus Duplessis. That was crazy. If I'd have parlayed all my underdogs together, I'd have been 5-6. Marc-Andre Barrio would have got me. But having said all that, we're gonna go ahead and get into the card for next week as I go ahead and slide over on Tapology. I hope everybody's having a phenomenal day. No cap. And I hope everybody's making money and had a good night. And just if you're even if you don't bet, I hope you enjoyed the fights. So with the first fight of the night, we got Thimba Kerembo versus Pete Rodriguez. And if we're just looking at Thimba Kerembo, I gotta go Thimba Kerembo sub. And to be honest with you, you got Thimba Kerembo, who's 1-0 as a favorite. Pete Rodriguez, who's 1-0 as a dog. If we're going to look at the tell of the tape real quick, we got Thimba Kerembo, 33, Pete Rodriguez, 27 years old. Both, we got 5'9 for Pete Rodriguez, 6'1 for Thimba Kerembo. 77-inch reach for Thimba, and then 73 for Pete Rodriguez. Honest to God truth, I just feel like Pete Rodriguez gasses out, and he's just going to he's gonna gas out, and then Thimba Kerembo is going to pretty much just take over. He's going to take over, and he's going to wear him out, beat him up, and then he's going to end up submitting him. He's going to rear neck and choke him. So in the first fight of the night, go ahead and give me the favorite in Thimba Kerembo to win. Next fight up, we got Charles Johnson versus Azat Maksim. We got Azat Maksim 17-0. We got Charles Johnson 13-6. Charles Johnson, he lost his last 3 fights in the UFC. So you just never know. You never know what's gonna happen. most of the time when you lose three fights in a row, you don't get a chance again. But I appreciate that. I appreciate the UFC giving us another chance to fade Charles Johnson for one final time. We're going to go ahead and fade him. Can Charles Johnson come in here and avoid the takedowns and be the more active fighter and more active striker? Absolutely. Is there a world where he's not doing that and he's doing the exact opposite and he's getting taken down at will? Absolutely. So, for second fight of the night, we're going to go ahead and just go Azat Maxim. And then we're going to go ahead and go, what is that? We're going to go ahead and go by decision. And the reason why I'm going to go decision is because I feel like Charles Johnson, he's been real durable in the UFC. And he's lost three straight decisions. So one could say it's just going to be another decision loss. And that's just been the pattern in his fights. You know, he just gets a lot of the time he's on the bottom, on the cage, just time ticking away, and he's losing the fight. Give me Azat Maxim. Next fight up. It's like, get it up. Next fight up. Actually, this order is off, but we'll go ahead and just do this order for the sake of the video. Next fight up is Molly Meatball McCann versus Diana Belbelziza. Diana Belbita. She's a, what is it, France? The weird princess. She's from Romania. She's sexy, too. But to be honest with you, looks don't pay the bills in this. We got Molly Meatball. She's coming off two straight L's. One loss to Aaron Blanchfield, that's not a bad loss. You know, you can't be too mad about that loss. And then she's coming off a loss to Julia Stolyarenko. I called that one. I actually called her last two fights. So one could say that I have a good grips on her fights. Yeah, it's going to be an excellent fight. But I just feel like Molly Meatball is going to take over. And I feel like she's just going to do her thing. Can Molly Meatball win? Absolutely. But I just feel like Molly Meatball is going to take over. And she's going to really just, she's going to just wear Diana Belbita out. So, yeah. Yep. Molly Meatball, let's go decision. Next fight up, we got Markel Merdos and versus Landon Quinones. And Markel Merdos, I jagged this name the first time. Markel Merdos, he was pretty green coming out of the UFC contender series, but he got that little nice little knee off that guy. What was his name? Alaskov. Yeah, man, that's pretty good. He beat a Russian guy. That's what's up. He's 6-0 to the knockout. That's definitely something I noticed. That was something I noticed in the film, too. I'm like, oh, yeah, he doesn't get chinned. He does the chinning. And in this bout, it's striker versus striker. What is Landon Quinones coming in here to do? He's trying to beat you up. He's trying to wear you out. But in the process, he's wearing himself out. So in them type of fights, you just never know. He just leaves himself vulnerable a lot too. He's 1-2 to the decision, so he's not a good minute winner, as one could say. And that's because of his cardio. If he doesn't knock you out, he's gonna just wear out. And he has never been finished in his career, so that's definitely something to be noted. Something else that I noted, Landon Quinones, he's 0-1 as an underdog, so the UFC kind of has a grip on his floor and his ceiling. Landon Quinones, he has 70-inch reach. I know he's at a disadvantage there because Medeiros, I think he's, 69. So, no, actually, they actually had the same reach. So, yeah, man, it's going to be a striker's delight. I smell striker's delight here, man. What's that smell? I smell action. I smell action here in this fight. I smell a lot of fists being thrown in this one. They get in a classic brawl. That's a look for my drink. But Yeah, man. I feel like Manderos, he's gonna just come in here and box him up, and he's gonna have the better gas tank, and he's gonna land him more strikes, and he's just gonna win by decision. So go ahead and give me the debutant in Medeiros to win. Yeah, Markel Medeiros to go ahead and get it done and advance to 9-1, baby. So yeah, man, let's go ahead and slide on to the next one, man. Hey man, leave a like on the video, leave a sub too. That would be highly appreciated. Next up, we got Blake Builder versus Yong Li Jing. Let's start that over. We got Blake Builder versus Zhang Yang Li. Yeah. I got my guy's name wrong, man. Because guess what? Although I jagged his name, that guy got hands for days. He's real tough. He's real active. He gets taken down, he wants to get right back up. But I just feel like sometimes that's the issue, is he can get taken down too much, maybe just a little bit too much. He gets taken down. So that's maybe something he needs to correct going forward. But I think in a fight like this, he's gonna definitely have to avoid the takedown. And my guy CJ, he got a Blake Builder in this one, and I could see the angle on Blake Builder, but Blake Builder also be gassing out though. So I gotta go Zhang Yang Li, and he's gonna get it done by decision. Got the better gas tank. We already seen we didn't already seen bro come in and beat him. We've already seen Kyle Nelson come in here and take him out. So like, come on now. He's gonna do the same thing now. Next up, we got Yulia Storyrenko versus Luana Carolina. And go ahead and give me the dog, man. Go ahead and give me Luana Carolina. I just feel like she's gonna avoid the submission, and she's gonna keep the fight on the feet, and she's just gonna stay away. She's gonna stay out of danger, and Yulia is just gonna have no answer for anything. And yeah, man, go ahead and give me Luana Carolina. Something I definitely noticed is Yulia Ostroyenko, she's 0-1 as the favorite, and Luana Carolina, she's 3-4 as a dog. So shit, at least she's shown up as a dog. She's shown up as a dog in her last one. So the bookies don't have a good grips on her at her full ceiling. They think that she's a scrub, and they think that she's brought into the UFC to lose, but that's not the case here. Yeah, let me go ahead and get Luana Carolina. So next up, we got Thomas Peterson versus Jamal Polks. And this is the last fight. This is the feature prelim, last fight on the prelims. So we got Thomas Peterson making his UFC debut. And we got Jamal Polks. This is the first time he finds himself in a UFC dog spot. So one could say that's a good EV bet if we're talking expected value. That's a good bet. Yeah, I feel like I just feel like Thomas Peterson's gonna come in here, and he's gonna control Mr. Jamal Polks, and he's just gonna do what he usually does, and that's grind people out, wear them out, beat them up, and usually he can fish for submissions, and he'll take the ground and pound too. I just feel like in this spot, man, Jamal Pogues, bro, he's old, bro. Jamal Pogues is old. One could say he's not old, but he's like, he moves like an old man. Like, he used to be a light heavyweight, and now he'd have moved up to a heavyweight. So he just moves like an old man. I don't know. Like, if y'all watch tape, bro, on this man, he's just fat and unathletic. You know, you can tell that if he really wanted to, and if he had a good nutritionist, and he was actually a professional, he would probably be a light heavyweight, but he's not a professional. Jamal Pigs. That's what his name is to me. And he'll be 10-5 after this fight. He'll find himself as a guy who only wins 75% of his fights. But yeah, man, it's all good. Shit happens. I gotta go with the train and Tom Peterson to win by decision or submission. I could absolutely see Tom Peterson choking this dude out, because most of the time, big fat heavyweights, they don't just ball up. They'll give a backup and then they get choked out. Give me the train to keep rolling. Next up, we got Randy Brown versus Muslim Salikov. And I feel like this is a great fight for Randy Brown. Randy Brown, he's 6-2 is in decisions. No, he's 6-2 is the favorite. That is a great tag you want to be in, being 6-2 as a favorite. That's not too bad. We got Muslim Salikov, and he's actually 1-0 as an underdog. So he doesn't find himself usually in his underdog tag. I feel like Muslim Salikov, he's getting up there in age, but you know, one could say that doesn't matter. Like one could say that, you know, he's supposed to roll in the spot, because, you know, if we're gonna be honest with you, Randy Brown didn't look too hot in that Wellington Thurman bout to me. I went back and watched that before this video. That was one of the last videos I watched, so that's fresh on the head right now. And he wasn't looking too hot to me. He had Wellington Thurman out there looking like Alex Bejeda. I ain't gonna cap y'all out, man. So let me go ahead and get Randy Brown in a not too confident bout. Gilbert Urbina versus Charles Radke. Go ahead and give me the motherfucking dog, man. Go ahead and give me the dog, Charles Radke. So I feel like Charles Radke gonna roll in this spot. Gilbert Urbina, it's the first time that he's been a dog. And we gonna see how he looks in this spot. Charles Radke, a guy who likes to grind, and he can definitely grind out for days, man. That's what he does. He can roll some time off that clock, man. And one could say he's a high power wrestler. Blood Diamond, a guy who's not really the most impressive win of all time, but he did that though. I feel like I don't know. I just feel like Gilbert Urbina is gonna tire out, and it's just gonna be over for him. If we look at the tail of the tape real quick. I feel like there's a world where Gilbert Urbina is avoiding the grappling, and he's doing everything he needs to do. If we look at the tell of the tape, 6-3 is 5-9, 75-73, and then Gilbert Urbina has the 6-year youth advantage. So yeah, he's 6 years younger than him. And he's longer than him. So one could say that Charles Radke definitely is not gonna roll here. And Gilbert Urbina is probably gonna roll, is what they're trying to say. But nah, go ahead and give me the dog, man. You can have him at a plus 106 right now in most spots. But let me go ahead and go to the next one. So we got Alice Gabb, Kharizbab versus Makhmov Meridov. And Alice Gerov versus Makhmov, that's going to be a pretty good fight. It's the featured fat bout on the card. We got the both 33 years old. Alice Gabb is coming off of almost a 2-year layoff. Mahmoud, he fought 5 months ago, so that's pretty good. He's the longer guy, he's the faster guy, and he fought more recent. So let me go ahead and get the dog in that spot to go ahead and take Alice Gobb's O. I got him getting his O taken. Yep, I sure do. I sure do. Vivia Russo versus Natalia Silva. And yeah, man. Natalia Silva, she's been rolling. She's been rolling since she's been in the UFC. She's been looking real good. She's 3-0 as a favorite. She was an underdog coming in versus Jasmine Jazz Davis, that we just seen her get a submission last week. That was pretty good. I thought that was good. Yeah, man. Everybody thinks Natalia Silva is gonna roll in this spot, but I think this might be the fight that we see Natalia Silva in the most in the biggest spots that we've ever seen her in. Like, we could see Natalia Silva on her back, because if you look at Natalia Silva's record, you would think like how is she 16-5? She's very pretty too, but man, that don't win you fights. Shoot, she got ground pounded by Kenya Miranda. She got submitted by Elaine Lee Leal. Then she lost to Kenya Miranda again. Then she lost to another chick named Diana Farmino, and then she lost to Marina Rodriguez coming in before she was in the UFC. That was actually a pretty good fight. Yeah, man. So she's had a really tough record. She really had a tough and wow, this chick Kenya Miranda, that's crazy. She has two wins. She literally has two wins over Natalia Silva, and she's not even a good fighter. So that is a little alarming, and I'm gonna put that on record right now and just say that's a little alarming. You know, you lost to a 50-50 fighter. If they fought twice and she won, she'd be 1-5. Or let's just say she'd be 1-4 because she would have had that spot versus Emily Ducote and Bellator. So yeah, kind of alarming, but I think she should roll in this spot. But you know what? I'm switching my pick, man. I'm switching my pick on my show, and I'm gonna let my guy CJ know that I switched the pick. Go ahead and give me Vivia Russo. And you know, I was watching Vivi just really grind chicks out when I was watching the tape, and you know, I just feel like that's gonna happen here, and I was nervous. I've been nervous about this pick, giving it to you guys. And if I'm gonna be transparent, you know, I gotta be transparent. I just gotta switch the pick, and I gotta go Vivi, because you know what did I have here? I had Natalia Silva by decision. Confidence was a 6, so that means 60% chance, 40% chance for Vivi. I'm gonna go 50-50. And in that case, I'm gonna take the dog. I'm always gonna take the dog in that spot. So yeah, give me the dog. Next up, we got Renato Moicano versus Drew Dober. And yeah, Renato Moicano has been a little bit of a layoff for him. I'll go ahead and announce that now. It's been just a tad bit of a layoff for him. He fought a year ago. He got the submission over Brad Riddell. Dober, he was coming off that knockout from Matt Favola. He got slept. Yeah, man. I definitely like the fact that you know, Renato Moicano, he's 7-2 as a favorite. And I hated the fact that Drew Dober's 2-8 as a dog. So based off of that, you gotta go Renato Moicano. He's gonna take Drew Dober's back, and he's gonna get him out of there. Is there a world where Drew Dober knocks Renato Moicano out? It's a world. It's a world, because we've seen Renato Moicano knocked out. But we've also seen Drew Dober submitted. So having said that, I gotta say, this fight's not going a distance, and you might just want to play it safe. But the official pick is Renato Moicano by sub, submission, sub sandwich. Hey, man, we got the main event, man. We at the motherfucking main event. Hey, man, if you got some motherfucking smoke, smoke up right now. I ain't gonna lie. I ain't roll up nothing. Shoot, I got some. I just got some new shit, but don't got it rolled. So I'm gonna hit the vape for the show purposes. And you know what? I double it up for y'all. Hold on. I double it up for y'all. About to double it up. Chicago, man. Chicago. We're gonna double up the dosage. If you got some smoke, smoke up right now. Now that's smoke. Main event. We got Nassourdine Imavov versus Roman the Bulldozer Dolize. And I call him the Bulldozer. His real nickname is the Caucasian. I call him the Bulldozer. Because what does he go in and do? He tries to impose his will on people. He tries to use his physicality. And he tries to just bully you. So that's his game. He tries to use his big shots to hurt you. And he tries to impose his grappling on you to get you tired before he gets tired. And honestly, this is a really weird fight because these are two guys that kind of remind me of each other. Like, you got Roman Dolize, who's 2-2 in decision. You got a guy in Nassourdine Imavov is 3-3 in decisions. So, yeah, bro. I feel like this is a fight where Nassourdine can maybe weather the storm. He can maybe avoid, maybe drop. I could see him dropping round one. Because honestly, you know, this is a very even fight, and I'll be the first one to tell you guys that now. I feel like Nassourdine Imavov can weather the storm, and I just think that he might have the better gas tank. I feel like Nassourdine, he'll definitely will establish his will. He will establish everything that he's trying to do. Versus what Roman Dolize, he'll be tired after the third round. You guys seen, he only has, honestly, 11 minutes of solid cardio. So, at the end of it, the start of the third round with 3 minutes and 30 seconds left, he'll be gassed. And that's when Roman Dolize will start not timing anything. The shots will be more telegraphable. And then that's when that's when Nassourdine will start beating him up and start cracking him. And then probably if he doesn't put him away, he's gonna win by decision. So go ahead and give me Nassourdine Imavov to win by decision. So we're gonna go ahead and go over the picks again. I'll give you guys my confidence rate and get y'all out of here. So let me go from the top. Thimba Garimbo, I got him by decision. Let me confidence rate probably a 5. Charles Johnson, Azat Maxim, I would go Exot, probably decision, probably 5. Molly Meatball, I'm gonna go ahead and go decision, and I'm gonna go ahead and give her I'm going to give her a decision, and she's going to win probably confident. She wins the fight 7 out of 10 times. Mikel Medeiros. I'm gonna go ahead and go Mikel Medeiros TKO or decision. I'm gonna go Zhang Yongli decision. The one in Carolina decision. Thomas Peterson decision. Randy Brown decision. Charles Radke decision. There's a lot of fights on this card. Mahmoud Miradov decision. Natalia Silva decision. I'm seeing a lot of decisions. Renato Moicano, Drew Dober. I gotta go Renato Moicano submission, and then Nasruddin Imavov decision. Hey man, that's the picks. That's that boy Gibbs, man. That's pretty much it for me. I'm going to go ahead and get out of here and watch some football, man. We got the Lions playing today, so I'm going to go ahead and enjoy that. I know it's probably going to be the Lions 49ers. I already know. So Lions 49ers, Ravens, Bills. That's my prediction. So when y'all watching it, y'all let me know if I'm right. But y'all have a good one, man. Take care.